This video shows revisions to my dust collection system. I think I'm at least 95% dust collected now. Hi, I'm Jim Vanderskaff, and welcome to my shop down East Woodart. Previously we did a video about dust collection on a table saw. This is a DeWalt 745 table saw. I've made some extensions to it, but I've revised that dust collection methodology, and I just wanted to share it with you. I put together a whole series of notes for myself so I make sure I don't miss anything. But the basic idea of this dust collection methodology is twofold. One, a mechanism for collecting dust on top that has its separate shop vac collection, and another method that sucks from the dust port in the back, and I'll show you those in detail. The system, as in many things in woodworking, we don't create it just with ourselves, with our own ideas. We get ideas from other people, and I want to share where two people that I've learned from, Dan Pattison from Canada and Justin Depew, also made systems that are similar to this, and I got great ideas from them. Also, the saw stop dust collection overarm method. I also picked up some ideas from that, and actually I think I've improved on it. So I just wanted to show you all the elements of this system. First of all, it comes apart. It easily slides on and off, and it has adjustment mechanisms here for going up and down for different size boards, because the back of it covers the board. And then this mechanism here slides down over the edge of the board. So if you're cutting a board such as this, with right on the edge, as you can see like that, which we'll demonstrate later, that's the worst situation for generating dust that you can imagine. And in order to handle that properly, I created this system that just has that portion of the dust collection system just fall down, be right tight to the table, and it just captures all the dust as it's pulled out by the vacuum. So, how is this thing made? Well, let's take a look at it piece by piece. These are separate, just little wing nuts that attach the sliding mechanism in the front. Just take those off. And then what I used is to make this, this is all made out of plexiglass. And I just cut another piece of plexiglass and glued that on. I found that this product works best for that kind of adhesion. It just takes a little bit, you've got some work time, and you can use that very effectively to glue this joint. So that's just little slots cut in there for the bolts. The bolts are embedded in the wood, as you can see here, and this is three pieces of half-inch plywood that I took a 1 3/8 bit and drilled a hole right down through here, which happens to fit this little coupling exactly, and then that happens to fit exactly on the exhaust hose. So this is just constructed and glued together and joined together, and then these little guys have inset nuts that allow me to move that up and down. Right here, I've got a little piece of wood that's screwed in place and glued in place and happens to just fit exactly into that overarm method. That is a piece of 1x1 then the whole thing pivots out of the way if I wish to do so. And that's handy several times if you need to work on systems that require the whole front part of the table saw available to you, like if you had a sled that was moving a piece across. That whole piece comes out, and I'll just show you that. That's just on a dowel, like this, and it just pivots on a dowel and swings back and forth. So that's the entire system. And what we'll do is show you the connection method for the hose. If you look underneath right here, that vacuum hose just connects all the way down to a shop vac right here. This hose through the dust port just comes off, and if you look down in there, Alex, take your camera, shoot down in there, that's the normal dust port for the DeWalt 745. That is connected in turn all the way back to a vacuum bag system from Rockler. So that's the whole system. What we'll do now is I'll show you what's underneath the saw, because that's part of the system as well. We'll just unplug the saw and take some of these pieces out of the way. Get to one side, I want to get over there, Alex, because I'm going to take this loose so we can flip it over. This just comes out. And now I'm going to go around the back of me, Alex. I'll flip the saw up and we can take a look at underneath. So, what I need is a pointer. All right, if you get all the way down in here and look over on this side, all the way in through here, you'll see that I've got tape on the system and a plastic piece that is taped in place just to close off all these openings that I could. So, that collects the dust from down below, and then it's sucked in through the dust port. I'll show you that from the top of the saw as well. If you want to come over on the other side, Alex, and look down in through here, all the way down in through here. Way down. Get the, okay, camera. See all that dust in there? That just collects, that can be sucked out, and that works very effectively to keep the dust from dropping down through the system. So we'll stop there and I'll set it up for cutting a piece and showing you the system. Okay, so I just wanted to demo at the end of this video how effective this system is. This is MDF. It's 3/4 MDF, and if you've ever cut MDF, you know that this stuff just sprays all over the place when you cut it, especially when you cut just the edge, like I'm about to do here. If you can see where I'm going to cut this, it's just right on the edge of the board. So I'll do it without the dust collection system, and then I'll add that on, and we'll do it with the dust collection system. Now, this stuff is terrible for your lungs. That's one of the reasons why I created this system. It's just, it's really bad, so you should never breathe it in. So anytime you work with this stuff, if you don't have a good dust collection system, just make sure you get one of these. All right, if you will. Was here before I didn't clean that up. The only thing you see is when the board went all the way through, you see a little bit in here, but it mostly sucked it up. You can see that evidence of it sucking up because it sucks it even between the two pieces of plexiglass. So that's it on this one. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want any dimensions to the size of this thing, I can give you those just very shortly. I've extended my table so that dimension is not useful to you, but I've made it 9 inches above the table. That's plenty of room. This is 11 inches long. It's about 4 1/4 inches high. Like I say, I've made it out of 3 pieces of half inch Baltic birch. Well, this is lower grade plywood, but this is Baltic birch on the outside. And then just a bunch of nuts and twist and wing nuts and things like that connected to a shop vac. So I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you picked up some pointers on this. If you need more dimensions or anything more about this, please leave a comment and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thanks and hope to see you in the next video. Bye bye.